वेलकम एवरी वन। इफ आई वॉन्ट टू से वॉट इज मैग्नेटिक पोल, मैग्नेटिक पोल इज द प्रेफर्ड रीजियन ऑफ अट्रैक्शन नियर द टू एंड्स ऑफ द मैग्नेट वेयर द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स ड्यू टू द बार मैग्नेट इज मैक्सिमम आर कॉल्ड द पोल्स ऑफ द मैग्नेट दैट वी हैव लर्न इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस दैट इज इफ इट इज अ बार मैग्नेट इफ इट इज कॉल्ड द जियोमेट्रिक लेंथ ऑफ द बार मैग्नेट If some iron filings is scattered over there around this region where this bar magnet is placed, then it is observed that slightly inside than that of the geometrical length, or you can say the end of the bar magnet, the region of attraction or repulsion is appears maximum. So these two points are called the poles. Later, it is due to the directive property of the magnet, if you just hold the bar magnet by using a string in air, okay, freely, then it will align itself along the north and south directions, and from that idea it is denoted as the north pole and it is denoted as the south pole. So these are the two magnetic poles of the bar magnet. The separation between the two poles, have a different name, and that is called the magnetic length. So if I say the magnetic length is 2L, then 2L is obviously less than that of the geometric length, okay. The magnetic length is obviously less than that of the geometric length. So this is the magnetic poles, that what we know in case of the bar magnet from the domain theory of magnetism and all of these things. But after that, a current carrying loop is considered as a magnetic pole. How it is? It is considered that if the current is flowing in that particular direction, okay, then here in that direction the north pole, if anyone observe this from this side, then the north pole is created, the south pole is created, because if anyone observe this, then the current flow will be in the clockwise direction, then the south pole is created, and obviously from these directions it will be anti-clockwise, so the north pole will be created. So considering the current carrying loop as a magnet, we can easily consider this thing. So this is the north and this is the south, so we can say that the current carrying loop is also behaving like the magnet. This is the north pole of it and this is the south pole of it. Now the idea of the magnetic dipole is introduced because the magnet have two poles, north pole and south pole, two opposite nature. The magnetic dipole moment can be denoted as small m vector, okay, this will be denoted as the capital M vector, the magnetic dipole moment, then small m will be any of this pole strength, 12 vector, and it is directed, and this magnetic dipole moment is directed from south to north. This is the direction of the capital M vector. Small m is the pole strength, that is the what is the force of, how much intense is the force of attraction at this point or at this point, any of this pole strength in the separation between the two poles, that is the, we can say the magnetic length. So this way the magnetic dipole moment is introduced, just like we have done in case of the electric dipole moment, P vector equal to Q12 vector. The magnetic dipole moment of a current carrying loop can be defined as M equal to current of this loop multiplied by the area of the loop, area of the loop. and if what is the direction of the m vector, that is the magnetic dipole moment, if I is the current flowing through the loop, then the direction of the area vector will be the directions of the dipole moment. Okay, so since it is ampere, since it is ampere and its unit is meter square, so the magnetic dipole moment can be represented as in SI unit is ampere meter square, and the direction of the magnetic dipole moment is perpendicular to that of the plane of the loop. And it is not that all the time the loop should be a symmetrical, loop may be of irregular shape, but the magnetic dipole moment is in the directions perpendicular to that of the plane of the loop. That means if the loop is simply like this, if the current flow is this, then this may be the direction of the magnetic dipole moment. So this is the magnetic pole and magnetic dipole. The magnetic poles cannot exist. We can say the magnetic monopole cannot exist, but the magnetic dipole can exist. Why it is? Because if you just cut a magnet into two equal halves, then two different magnets build up. If you say it is north and south, then if you just cut it, it will be maybe your assumptions that it will be north and it will be south. You just divide it, a magnetic dipole into two magnetic monopoles or magnetic poles, but it is not possible. This south pole will be appeared here and north pole will be appeared here. So the magnetic monopole does not exist. And another thing that I want to say, the additional information, that is if you cut these poles, if you cut this magnet into two equal halves, then if its magnetic pole strength is small m, its magnetic pole strength will be m by 2 and m by 2. That is, if you cut a bar magnet perpendicular to that of its length, then its magnetic pole strength gets halved. But if you just cut it like this, that is along the length, this is north and this is south, then this will be the two halves. This is north, this is south, this is north and it is south. At that time, the magnetic poles does not change. If its magnetic pole strength is m, then its magnetic pole strength will be also m, and its magnetic pole strength will be also m. These concepts are needed when you are doing some kind of numerical problems or applications. That is, if you cut a magnetic bar magnet into two equal halves perpendicular to that of this length and along the length, then the two cases are completely different. It is m by 2, but it is m and m. So this is roughly, we can give you the idea of magnetic poles, okay, and magnetic dipoles, magnetic dipole moment, direction of the magnetic dipole moment in case of the bar magnet, in case of the current carrying loop. And if you just cut it into two equal halves perpendicular to that of its length and parallel to that of its length, and how the magnetic pole strength is changed. Along with that, we have discussed here what is the geometric length of bar magnet and what is the magnetic length of the bar magnet. Okay, I think it is clear to you. So, thank you.